I'll do a little recording of this anyway. Right, let's just do a very gentle warm-up. We're going to look at the Fasun Gong exercises, which are on this bit of paper here. Which I've got. I can almost remember them all, but it's good to have them there as a little crib sheet. So just what we're doing, just sink your hips. So the hips sink back and down, and we're nice and tall. And the head floats up, and we're nice and relaxed, and just letting the palms go. Relax the wrists, relax the elbows and the shoulders. We're going to turn the waist. So yeah, the dad that got in touch saying he could do, his 10-year-old do something, that they just want to do something with other children. And I said, well, we haven't really got any other children here, unless you wanted to bring some. But they're going to try and find something else. So that was good. Never mind. Would have been quite fun, I think.
Me and Dad would try fencing, I thought.
Fencing? Wow!
Yeah.
Was it good?
We haven't tried it.
Oh, let me know. That sounds exciting.
Yeah.
Where's that then?
Netherhall School.
Oh, Netherhall. Yeah. I've seen them do that. Yeah, that's on the same time as there's martial art class, I think. What did you think of it? Was it good?
Yeah.
Oh.
Did you feel like a pirate?
Kind of.
Okay. So just feel the ground under your feet. You want to sink the hips. And just breathe in and out and just tune in to your sense of balance and rooting. So you're rooting and centered. Breathing, very good. Oh, so yeah, hopefully the traffic will be completely clear by the time we get back. It should be not. No, it was completely.
Maybe we'll just go back to Sky or something.
No, it's still awful. I mean, it's just rush hour. I think rush hour's between 4 and 6, and then there's a sneaky way I go around the back, but they've put a bike barrier there, so only bicycles could get through, and I was like, oh no. So I think it's good that they've done it, because obviously there were loads of cars that were just belting through, and now they've been thwarted, which I highly approve of, just not when I'm trying to get somewhere on time. So I had to turn around to go back, and I wasn't the only car that got caught out. There's 4 cars, and we were on a turn around, and they were like, oh, when it's blocked off. So you just want to relax your shoulders and breathe in and out. So, and then 10:30 till 12 here, we've got a thing called Tai Chi and tea. And what we've done is we've worked out, we have a tea break at half time. And it's brilliant. So you can have your tea break before we start here, or you can have it at half time. But it was very, very good, and it worked really well. So you just want the knees to go forward and back, and then nice and tall. Oh, it's the lady with her, that dog.
With her dog.
Yeah.
What was it called? Judy or something?
I can't remember. It was just very, very nice coat. I remember that one. So we're just sinking down. And really let go of that lower back muscles. And just allow your arms to be moved. Just let them go. Really let the arms go. And then we'll just 4, 3, 2, 1. We'll just open the arms. So I won't spend too long on loosening or anything. I just want to do some basics. I look at this Fasun Gong thing. I think they're all on too, aren't they? If you want the heating on, put it on if you want a bit of warmth. knees start to get cold, isn't it? So again, watch the knee alignment. And keep breathing. And then just let the arms go. Oh. Let the arms go, that's it. And open the palms of the hands, relax the wrists, relax the fingers. Sink the hips so the head floats up. Chin tucked away, chin slightly tucked in. And we're all breathing very nice. Yeah, Friday was fun, wasn't it?
Yeah.
We both managed to get, we were early to the 9 o'clock class, which was very impressive, and then we did the 11:30 class, and that was good too. It was really fun. So you can always look at the video after and do it in your own time. You don't have to. Yeah, that's any of the classes. If you can't make them, just do them anyway. So I've been doing some of Mike's online classes because I can't make. In the Monday class, I can't make the last 10 minutes, so I have to do it later today. Four, three, two, one, and then we just let the arms, really let them go, but lengthen. Keep breathing.
She's
done Tai Chi before, your mum.
No, not really.
She does like sporty stuff, like badminton and that, isn't it?
Tennis.
Tennis, yeah. Mm. She's probably a bit slow for her.
She used to be Pilates.
Oh. Mm-hmm. Okay, sure. Practice our bow and arrow stance. So we turn the foot out and then keeping the same gap between the heels. And then you will need to adjust. Make sure your hips and shoulders are square onto the opposite wall. And it's very slowly and carefully going to sink through the front foot. Then we're going to sink down through the back foot. Just going to do that. Sink back and turn, sink forward and turn. So you're sinking down through the back foot, then you turn to the corner, you sink down through the front foot, you turn to the front. Keep breathing some more, very good. something that, and then we're sinking through the back, through the front. So as you sink, that's what brings up your head. So you can still float up with the head, but just make sure you're hanging. So it's like these are hanging down, in a way. And we're all breathing. So, yeah, I had a chat with Mike about the t-shirts.
Ooh.
Yay, t-shirts, because they're, I mean, mine are starting to get a bit worn now. I want some new ones. He said, well, I'm thinking about a redesign. And I was like, but the problem is, he said, with a redesign, it could take some time, couldn't it? I said, yes, Mike, it could. What about this? Well, I know I'm going to contact Talking Tees and see how much it would be to just print the ones that we've already had for years. Just for, you know, he can do a redesign, but I mean, redesigns take forever. And he wanted something very simple, like maybe the herons and the thing, and just have that. And with a something quote from something with the herons on the back or something. Like really simple, which I think, but it just, he's got to go think about it. But he's notoriously, now sink back and turn, he takes forever to do stuff like that. So I think we'll probably just get the same ones. But we'll have to, because everything's gone up, we're not sure how much they'll be, the training t-shirts. And he's got to make sure that he covers what he spent to have them all printed and all that. So. You know, but we're, it looks like we're, yeah, we'd have to do pre-orders, but the thing is, you're not quite sure how big they end up or small. And they're basically going to be black and green, or black and pink again, like normal, because we've thought of other colours, and they're, no, that would be horrible, that would be horrible, that would be horrible. They're the best ones for that thing, so. Anyway, let's do two turns. One. Two, but nice and slow. We're doing kind of snail kung fu. So look, you do two turns through the front foot, you do two turns through the back foot, you do two turns through the front foot, two turns through the back foot. That's it. It's quite tempting to sometimes just do one, and then you're quite sure to do two, and then you think, no, I'm not, I'm just doing one turn, I'm going to do two. So front foot, one, two, back foot, one, two, and if you do that in your head, then you'll remember that to do it. And we're breathing, very nice. And just take it easy. So do some Qigong. And one side feels different to the other. So you want to make sure that you've set your posture up so the front foot is pointing towards the front wall, the back foot is somewhere towards the corner, and then that'll be easier to get the movement. So it's all about the setup. Okay, now let's do it on the other side. So we bring the foot in, check your Wu Qi first. So we just like, right, okay, great. And then, so what one thing Mike's been talking about in his classes is punctuation. So it's like you spend a little bit of time having like a mini pause before you do stuff. You go, right, does that feel right? Right, now I'll move on. So he says it's like having a comma. And I was like, okay. But anyway, it's like you want to take your time. You want to take your time and check things are in the right places first before you move. And then it works better because you've set it up. It's like if you're making a cake, you've got to get it, you know, you've got to do all the measuring properly and then put all the things in the right order and then mix it all up and then you bake it and then you have to get all the timings right and get everything just so and then you get this amazing cake. So I got sent a lovely picture of a cake, which isn't quite the same as eating one, but it was nice to see and I was like, really impressive. But it's very like, you know, if you prepare it right, it's much easier. If you prepare the cake right, it's much easier for the cake to turn out okay. Or pretty good, if you're lucky. And it's the same thing with this. If you prepare it right, we'll get a better result. Okay, now just very gently, just go forwards and back. Forwards and back. A little bit faster this one. And you want to keep your feet flat on the floor. Keep your feet flat on the floor. So you want to move with less enthusiasm in order to keep the feet attached. You can do it more enthusiastically and the feet do move, but we're doing it like this at the moment. It's like you're on a trampoline, but there's glue on it, so your feet are kind of stuck. And you want to relax your shoulders, relax the arms. Use the legs to move the arms. Use the legs to move your arms. Okay, let's change. So set yourself up first. Get your feet in the right. Remember, it's like you're making a cake. But so you wouldn't use a cake to punch people. Well, maybe you could. I don't know. It doesn't quite. You can only take this image so far.
Custard pies.
Custard pies. Yeah. Now that's the cake you can hit with. So just. Feet breathing, very, very good. That's it. Now relax around the lower back. So let your lower back sink the hips. Fantastic. Okay, let's do some basic stuff that we can all do, and then we'll have a look at this bassoon gong as well, because that's really nice, a deep relaxation exercise. But let's just get ourselves in our feet and gather around, and we'll just breathe in. Breathe out. So we won't. Palms up. Breathe out. Sink the hips. Palms down. So we're in a not hurry. So it's about how to move. And feeling very solid in the feet. And just for fun, hang on, we'll do some slow ones. Just for fun, we'll do some faster ones, just to see what it feels like. Okay, one more slow one, and then faster. 1, 2. Oh, isn't that weird? 3, 4.
We're doing
keep
class now.
6, 7. But keep it soft. 8, and then back to slow. Super slow. Open the palms. Open the palms and hands. That's it. Open the palms. There we go. So you can do things at different speeds. I've done that with Carell, my main teacher Carell, and it's I think I prefer it slower. Fast was a bit like bit effortful, wasn't it? So let's try this one. Wild goose flies. So you come like this. And then you open as you go down. Yeah. And tall. Relax around the jaw, very good. We won't do this one fast because that'd be exhausting. And then we just relax. We can do a fast cloud hands, that's quite fun. Let's do one more. Oh, lovely. Okay, posture check. Breathing, so we're just taking our time, and then we go part the clouds. So yeah, it's got really autumny, hasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
I was noticing this morning when I was out there, and like there were leaves starting to fall everywhere, and it was a bit chilly, and although the sun was nice, but it was a bit chilly, and just noticing. And you're on Zoom on Thursday, is that correct?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll make sure you and Darren get the linky things. I did send you the big linky things from Mike, but that email goes on forever, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, I'll just send the basics, just for what we want, because it's like, that's a lot to read. And then you go, one more. Oh, nice. So, it's really nice to do simple stuff like this. Dragon plucks the stars from the sky. So we go up. So, and pull down. So in, I think it might have been either Burwell or Ely. Because we were doing Dragon plucks the stars from the sky. And I was talking about this lovely dragon and these lovely stars pulling down. How relaxing it is and blah, blah, blah. And at tea break, someone came up and was, do you know what it reminds me of? I said, no, what's it remind you of? Like when you're pulling those old style toilets with the flush. And I was like, oh, thanks. Yeah, that's a nice image, isn't it? Dragon pulls the toilet chain. I think, no, I'm sticking with my stars,
yeah.
Thank you very much. But if it helps, or it's a bit like bell ringing, you know, when they pull the bells. That's more like that, but they sink their hips.
Oh, no.
They have to sink their hips in order to ring the bell. Okay, we'll take a slightly wider stance and get into a not particularly enthusiastic horse stance. So you can have the feet parallel, or you can have the feet out a bit, it's quite good for balance. And we're just going to practice transferring the weight. Transferring the weight. So it's gone real sort of fundamentals and just getting the body in the right thing. We can start looking at form when Chris gets back. So she got the COVID after.
Well, she was on the cruise apparently. So it was a disaster because she had a cold and then she got COVID.
Well, don't go on a cruise. I mean, you know, the problem is with them boats is they're full of people and we're all sharing the same germs, isn't it? So that'll teach her. Should have gone to the activities thing in the woods. What you done when you were up, what was it, go ape?
Yeah, that's
you
it.
See, you're outside, there's fresh air, you can't get no germs from there.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you can fall out the tree, but you can't get no germs from it.
You can't really fall out the tree either, because you're all harnessed up.
Oh, you're harnessed up. Oh, well, there you go, that's even safer than being on the boat. Brilliant, right. Transfer the weight and turn. Transfer the weight. Keep breathing some more. And then we're just going to do this. Come out, down, transfer the weight, turn. Silk breathing. We make a nice circle. Now, the other hand, you can leave it hanging, or there's a couple of options. You can monitor your dantian as it turns by putting it there. Or you can monitor the opening and closing of your hip by resting it on the muscle of the top of your thigh. So whatever you like. Or you can just have the arm hanging. That's three options. Three options. I'll try that. And we go round. Yep. Katsu and Gong, I think what I might do, just to get us all nice and chilled, is put the music on, see if it works with the music. Because we quite like that. That was so good. Let's do that on the other side. So get yourself like that and then have the hand out like that. And then you can have your hand there, there, or there, whatever works. Turn. It kind of cuts down. It's like you're chopping something. And then you... And we're all breathing. Now it's starting to get dark already. Whoa, until the nights are drawing in. Gosh. So, and then it starts getting light after the 20th of December, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
well, we look forward to that. Not long. Not long before it starts getting light again. So, yeah. So we just do that. So you want to feel the ground. Feel the ground, feel the hips sink. Sink your hips and turning. And you want to watch the alignment of the knees with the toes. So it's all comes round. And then we put them both together. Oh, we put them both together. Now this is the one where we get to do it at super speed. So you can bring your feet in a bit now, because then it's a bit easier on the legs. But still sink your hips. And there's this round shape, nice round shape. You turn. This is really good for the brain, this one. That's fine. It's fine. Do something. It's fine. It's fine. It'll come out in the wash. Just do a thing. And then it comes. So at the top, it goes out from the middle. At the bottom, it goes into the middle. At the top, it goes out. At the bottom, it goes in, if that helps. And we're all breathing. Oh, that's so nice. And then for fun, you can go a bit quicker. So just try a little bit quicker. Just a little bit quicker, not hugely quick. And then you can go even faster. So I did this with Corel. It's really fun, isn't it? It's quite good. Whee. There we go, and sink the hips though. And you want to, the faster you move, the more relaxed you want to be. So go even more relaxed, even more relaxed. So this is just, and see how fast you can, oh my goodness, gosh. Okay, and then you go relax, and then let's slow down. Oh, it's like being in a washing machine. And then you go around. It's good, isn't it? Try a bit faster again, so start speeding up the train, and then just get a little bit faster each time and see how fast you can go. And keep breathing. So you wanna keep control. So what you wanna do is the faster you move, the smaller you wanna make the movements. Okay, now try doing this small. Really, really teeny tiny small. Oh. So you can do little ones as well. So you can practice with different speeds. You can also do like different volumes or sizes. So you've got. Now try a bit bigger. Look, see? So it's different ways of looking at things. How exciting. Shake it up. Good stuff. Oh, that works your legs, doesn't it? Should we do that one? Yeah, let's do that one. I'll show from the diagonal view for the people on the video thing. Inspect the horse's mouth, because we've almost got that sus, haven't we? Roll the back, and then it goes for the back corner. Then ward off, and then double-handed push. So when Mike does double-handed push, it's a lot more subdued. It just sort of, it's very subtle. So you want to sink into the back leg. Now this is like a spring being squashed. So you squash the spring, and then when you release the spring, it's doing like that. Oh, we forgot, yeah. Inspect the horse's mouth. It's very easy to muddle up the part of the horse's mane, isn't it? Then you roll over, very, very small movement, and then you sink. And And then you turn. And then you turn to the front. Then you sink back, sink back. And then you, one, two. That's it. Yeah, much better. Soft, smooth and slow. Three. And then the fourth movement, double hand push. And once more, hold the ball, inspect the horse's mouth. Roll back. Ward off. Double hand push. Brilliant, that was so good. We'd better do it on the other side, otherwise we'll be lopsided, won't we, if we don't do it on both sides. So you want to set yourself up. Remember, you want to sink the hips. You want to feel that you're correctly aligned vertically. And then you get yourself, and we're just checking our feet. And then once we check the feet, now we sink into the back leg and turn to hold the ball. This knee's still pointing where the toes point. Inspect the horse's mouth. Roll back. So it's all in the legs. You want the movement directed by the legs. So you turn first, then you transfer the weight. Separate the hands, sink into the back foot. Through the back foot, through the front foot. Sink into the back foot, turn to hold the ball. So now you hold the ball. Now you transfer the weight, turn to the front, the hands follow. Turn over, transfer the weight and turn, the hands follow to the back corner. Nice and tall through the head, then you turn to the front and then you push to the front. That's it. And then you separate the hands, double-handed push, sink back and turn, transfer the weight, respect the horse's mouth, roll back, very good. And nice. Let's stop for a quick water break and then we'll have a look at this Fasun Gong thing. But we'll just warm the legs up a little bit and we'll do some leg swings just to kind of get our legs working a bit more. Any questions so far? I think it's a bit better to do less stuff, isn't it? But yeah. More reps of less stuff.
Yeah.
That seems to work a bit better. It goes in more, doesn't it? Otherwise you can do something, then you do something, and then you do, and then by the time you've kind of, your brain's melted and you don't know what you're doing. So, I don't know if my friend Jane's coming, she's the drummer lady that plays in a jazz band, she turns up at 7 o'clock. So what we'll do, we'll just do this one, just to kind of get your opposite. 6, 7, 8, 2, 2. So this is one of Emma's. 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Very good. And then we're just going to swing the leg up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Just to get our legs. 7, 8, 2, 2. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Nice. Okay, next, transfer your weight, go into cat slots. Now, if you need to use a ball, have the leg on the outside. And it's perfectly fine to use a ball if you need to. So we just go up like that, and we go, whoops, 1, 2. Hang on, start again. 1, 2, so that's where you need to take the time. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, other way. 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, up, down, 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 in, out, in, out, in, out, in, out, shake it all about. You put your left leg in, your left leg out, well, that's enough of that, and then you swing round. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It's very good for developing your balance. And then the other side, well, it was showing you can't balance at all. 3, 4, five, six, seven, eight. Well, that's enough of that. And then you just give your legs a wiggle. Wiggle, 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 wiggle. Wiggle your whole body. That's another one from Everton Scuba. She does all the silly ones. I really like them, though. Like, the chicken shakes its tail feathers is my favourite. We'll do that one at some point. It's one of the silliest exercises ever invented. So, now we just see. But you want to feel your feet. Feel your legs. Good, strong legs. Nice, flexible arms and torso is the idea. So we'll just get... Now take your time to get in this position first. Then when you lift the leg up, you shouldn't wibble about so much. One, two, three. But it's okay. Five, six, seven, eight. Other way. One, two, three, four. So you want to sink the hips. Five, six, seven, eight. Up, down, 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 up, down. Then two, three, four, five. Nice. Six, seven, eight. Roundy, roundies. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Other way. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Fantastic. What we're going to do now, you're just going to swing that around. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Our direction. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So you can do it like this with the leg bent, but that's a bit like hard work, whereas this way it just swings out, and that's the way I've done with the scubas. Three, four, five, six, seven, and eight, and we go in. Lovely. Two, three, four, five, whoops, six, seven, and eight. It's good, isn't it? Really good. And then having mobile legs means then you can do your kicks, and that's quite cool. And it's another one. It's a good way of developing your balance. I mean, I've got a, in our garden, I've got a punch kick bag, big punch thing, that a standing up punch bag that's got water in the bottom, so it just stands up. But what I've noticed when I kick it, it's much harder than kicking the air, because then you really lose your balance and you just sort of fall all over the place. So get one for your garden. It's really good, because then it means you can be nice and calm, because you've let it all out on the bag. And you do it very, very relaxed on the bag, and it builds up your bones, it builds up your coordination, and it works your balance, and it works your heart. It's all brilliant. So I try and use the kick bag about three or four times a week. I try and do it now. Just for about 5-10 minutes, not very long, that's all you need. And you're just really, really, really good. But it's nice to get nice, relaxed legs that are very solidly connected to the ground. So that's the plan. But anyway, we'll just look at this Fa Sun Gong. So the first one's called Balancing Yin and Yang. And all you do is you just track up. Oh, I put the music on, sorry.
Get it right, Farah. I'll put
these on. And the first one's called Balancing Yin and Yang. Now, these were developed from Chen style, but they're really applicable to any style of Tai Chi. Just because it's all the weight shift, all the principles are the same, and they're good to do. Very, very nice, actually. Very nice. I'll just put what? The... birdie on. Oh, that's nice. We've got the little birdie, and then we've got the soaking music. There we go. That's suitably. The problem is with this music, you've got to be really careful with it, because don't listen to it when you're driving the car, because it's so relaxing. But for this, for the purposes of the Fa Sun Gong, it's ideal. I'll come a bit closer, because hands and feet are here. So, we just transfer the weight. Transfer the weight. We're nice and tall. So this is the first movement, movement number one. And it's balancing yin and yang. Yin, yin and yang. So you've got the weight from side to side. And you just want to relax. Really feel very relaxed when you're doing this. And that's the basic. This is what the whole of the set of movements is built up on, this rocking from side to side movement. So you want your hips sinking, your knees nice and relaxed, this tall feeling through the head, and you're just breathing. And then you just raise the heel, put the heel down, raise the heel, put the heel down. So it's like Mark said, was imagine you're making the wine, you know, when they make wine, they crush all the grapes in their feet. I mean, it sounds disgusting, doesn't it? I didn't know that, but apparently that's what they do. But it's like you're squishing. Maybe you've got a nice big thick carpet and you're just feeling the carpet. So it's something like that. Sink. Eventually, what you try and do is try and make the transition smooth. So he didn't go up and down as much. So try it that way and see if that. It's a bit strange, but it kind of works. So that's the first movement. The second movement is called turning the wheel. So you imagine you've got a big wheel in front of you, a big wheel, and then what you're doing is you come up, down, actually I'll do it from the diagonal, down and in. Then the other hand comes up, out, down and in. Imagine a wheel, there's a wheel in front of you, up, down, in. So he did it in the middle first. And then you transfer the weight up, down, and in, up. So he did this slowly, he didn't do it fast, but there's nothing wrong practicing at home and seeing what it would be like to do it super speed, just cause, you know, it's good to try things out, but just for now we're doing it at slow motion, what I like to call snail kung fu, after it's just got out of bed, really slow. Circling the wheel. Now, turning the wheel. We're turning the wheel. Nice. Okay, I think we've turned that wheel. Let's do circling the wrist. So it's like this, and then you go like that. And then what he did is he went back a bit, and then he went forward a bit. And you want to just keep the shoulders really, really, really relaxed. Oh. So we'll see how far we get. I want to try and get all through all 12 of these. So what you want to do is you want to sink the watch, sink the hips, sink the shoulders. Sink, so it comes in and then it goes like that. That's it. Just really relax. So chilled, really relaxed. And then you do it with a weight transfer. He did have a breathing pattern. Slow, just breathe whatever works. And then you can raise your heel, like what we were doing earlier. So there's only two movements where there's no heel raise movements, 11 and 12. All the others have this heel raise thing going. So, and it really works your legs. So you just raise one of the heels, the other one will solid in that leg. You want to be solid in the leg, sink into the foot. Circling the wrists. And last one, very nice. Just let the arms relax. And we stay in the middle and we do pressing the palms. So it starts like this. You squish them and then it comes up. Just turn it around. Transfer the weight, so you transfer the weight, that comes, one goes up, one goes down, so pull that down, then as you come back to the middle, you circle and squash, and then you can don't worry if you don't get it, it's a bit complicated this one, isn't it? It's quite complicated, and you can do the one with the heel raise, so you can just raise the heel and it's a bit easier then. Okay, next. So you have hands like this, and then one goes to the front, and up, one goes down. And you bring the hands back, and do it the other side. Parting the waves, parting the waves. That's it, yeah. Just keep your arms nice and soft, and then you do it with a heel lift. So just raise the heel down. Is called marching. So you have the palm out as if someone's just handed you a cup of tea, then you turn it over and just let it hang down, and then you do it the other side. So you come up and down. Up, down. Up, makes it very nice. So you come out with this open feeling and then soft, very soft in the hand. One more time each side. And then the next one is swinging the arms, which we've done, but it's a bit of a strange one. So he goes like that, but very slowly, very slowly, and it's not like how we do it normally. But then what we do is he transfers the weight, transfers the weight, transfers the weight, transfers the weight, and you can do it that way. As well. How would that work? I think he does it like that as well, which is a bit weird. But you can, I suppose there's two directions, isn't there? I think I prefer this one, it seems to make more sense to me. It's a bit like, because then it's a bit like when you're doing your punches, it seems to work better, so we'll do it that way. But
saying that,
that's
hard with your feet.
It's weird, because having the feet in it, it just adds an extra thing to it. But it's very relaxing. And then we've got the eight offers fruit. So what you do is you just come up like this. And then he just comes down. I think he does that. Do it with the weight shift. Have some fruit. Or it's more like, I mean, it's probably a big cake. Maybe it's an ape offering a ginormous cake. I think that would work better. And then you can raise the heel off the foot. And then you come down. Then you just let the heel gently come up. So you're not lifting the heel, you're just allowing it to be naturally brought up. All the human beings are the white ape, apparently. I'm not sure. I'm not sure. Or it could be referring to the gibbon. In China, they have them gibbons, and they have big white fur everywhere, and a very nice, very dark face, and they're very good at swinging around trees. So they'd love to go ape, but they wouldn't need a harness. And then, yeah, it's the gibbon. It's a special type of a gibbon that they find in China. And they're definitely an ape and not a monkey or something, I think, from what I remember. Look it up on Google. Is a gibbon a monkey or an ape? Gibbons, I think they're brilliant. I love gibbons. I saw some at Monkey World. They're amazing. It was the white one as well, white with the dark face from China. Amazing.
Where's Monkey
World? Dorset. You should go. It's amazing. It's all. It's got monkeys and apes, and they're all part of programs, so eventually they can get put back in the wild and stuff. So that that's their plan. I mean, whether it will work or not, but they've got all sorts, and they move amazingly. And they're very nice. And one more. Okay, now we've got shooting palms, which you just brush your hands against each other like that. So you have the hands open all the time. And actually I'll do that from the diagonal. And then you do it with the weight shift. And it's quite nice because you get it's good for coordination. So you physically touch your hands, then you raise the heel. So as that comes back, that comes forward, I'll show from the side. So they're matching, they're balancing each other, the hands are balancing each other. That's it. So it looks simple, but it's actually quite, there's some subtleties in there. Okay, now the next two don't have the weight transfer. Well, they have the weight transfer, but different. So the next one is called Phoenix Rises from the Ashes. Isn't that a great name? Phoenix Rises from the Ashes. So, so the palms face out. So you go into, and apparently you're supposed to do 20 each leg. No, we're not going to do 20, otherwise we'll be here all day. But we're going to, so it's like that, okay, so that the hands go like that, and they sort of touch and out. And you, like you're diving, but in a weird way. So go down like that, and you make an angle shape, and you've got your leg forward. Oh, you want your leg forward, put your leg forward, and the hands like that. Now you transfer your weight, you sit to your hips back. It's a bit like touch the sea and look up at the sky in a way, but you do that funny shape, the hands make a funny shape. So it's not quite as, it's a little bit more, at the moment, I prefer the sea one because it's a bit less artificial than this, but this is quite good because you can do, feels like you're doing usual things in the shoulder joint, and then you come up, down, and you come up, and just try and come up less enthusiastically, just make this not a big movement. So by the time you've done this 20 times, you should have got it.
Really?
6, we're going to do it 10, 7, 8, you can feel it doing useful things for your legs, can't you? 9 and 10. Fantastic. Right, then we do 10 on the other side, otherwise we'll be wonky. So get your gong bu, get your bow and arrow stance done, and we're doing this movement and then this movement. This movement, so like that. This one out, so I'll add that in. 4. I read the wrong line, but this is still good. 5. Sorry, Bart. And we're not even doing 20 either. 6. We're doing 10. 7. So the hands come together, and it's like you're pointing down. That's it. So imagine you've got a rainbow between your palms, and then you transfer the energy from palm to palm. It comes down, and then it goes over there, like that. And then it's just quite, you don't lift it too high, you keep it quite low, and you transfer the weight, and then you transfer the weight, and you're nice and relaxed. So it's just ways, sneaky ways of getting you to shift your weight. Sneaky ways to shift your weight, and just to get you to practice that going from one foot to the other and really feeling that transfer of the weight. And then I'm lifting the heel now. He didn't say how many of these you did actually, but that's what we'd done before the Phoenix. So this is what happens before you do the Phoenix. You transfer the energy from one palm to the other palm. Transfer the energy from one hand to the other. It's like a slinky spring. Mm-hmm.
You're really getting energy, isn't it?
It's good, isn't it? It's nice. Okay, and then the last movement, you're just doing the concluding move, which we all know. We just do that. That's all 12 of the movements. We got there, didn't we? We did all of them.
Was it roughly about 20 of each?
I don't know. I mean, I tend to do 8 of everything or 10 of everything, and then that seems to have covered it. But you could do 20 of everything. I mean, you'd get a good workout if you did. Yeah, he doesn't actually say, he doesn't say it's just for the Phoenix, there's 20, but nothing else. There's no mention of numbers, of any description. It's weird, apart from the number of the move. So we'll just do it with a heel lift. So we'll just do this first. One, two, three, nice. And four. Well, that was easy enough. And then we go one, two. So that was the turning the wheel. So that was first the balancing yin and yang, turn the wheel, three, four, circling the wrists, one, two, pressing the palms. One. Two. Three. And four. Parting the weight. One. Two, three, and we're doing it faster than normal as well, just to kind of remind us. So this is like the whistle stop tour. Four, march. It's not like normal marching, is it? Four. So I don't know why they call it marching. That's not marching. Anyway, and then swinging the arms. Yeah. One. Oh, that's what reminds me. Two. Three. Four. Eight offers fruit. One. Two. Oh, one. Sorry. I can't count anymore. Two. Now I can.
That's very silly.
Okay, and then we've got shooting palms. One. Two, I'll do it for the diagonal. Three. Four. And then one, put the energy from one palm to the other one. Two. Rises from the ashes. We'll just do four each though. One, two, three, and four. Nice. Other side. Get the legs sorted out first then. One. Two, three, and four. Yes. And then we'll do four of these. One, two, three, last one, four. Yeah, that's all 12.
That works to make the
movement. It's nice. It's very good. It's relaxing, but it also murders your legs. Brilliant. Right, I'll just switch off the lovely music, because that will just send us the... I might... keep the shall I keep the bird song going? Do we want the bird song keeping going?
It's kind of right. Affecting my hearing aids.
It's what?
It's affecting my hearing aids.
Oh, okay, I'll switch it off then.
It's making it a little uncomfortable.
Okay.
That's
a good song, though. It is nice, yeah. Okay, we'll carry on. Well, the thing is, we're going to be punching. We probably don't want tweety birds and lovely relaxing music in there.
Yeah, you've got to punch
your birds. Yeah, we're not going to punch the birds. So, what we're going to do, because we were looking at this movement, so what we're doing now is we're going to transfer the weight and sink down and face that wall. And we're going to transfer the weight and sink down and just get that. And actually, we're going to do it with the arms first. So, we just do that. And, oh gosh, it's nearly seven. Yeah, I think that. I'll give them the key. We pass the key.
Okay.
We just do that. And what we're doing, so that's what's happening in the body. So you transfer your weight and turn. Transfer. Actually, I'll do it from the back. So we're going to that side. Transfer the weight. Transfer the weight. Transfer the weight. Transfer the weight. Transfer the weight, 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 transfer the weight. Oh, fantastic. Right, then what we're doing is we're combining that body movement with this arm movement. So we have our guard up like this, just show it like that, and we're going there to there and back, and there to there and back. So you have your guard up, so you want your elbows down, and you want a straight wrist. So you want a straight wrist, so look at your wrist, make sure they're as straight as you can. So that's bent, that's straighter. So you want to try and get it in the middle. And then you keep that where it is. So you want to relax, have a softer, if you have a softer fist, then that will make that easier to get that straight. If that's too tight, you want to be nice and relaxed. And then what we're doing in very slow motion, we're just doing that with our arm. That's it. And then we bring back, and then we do that, and we bring back, and we do that, and we bring it back, we do that, and we're breathing. Here we go. And you want to keep your shoulders down. So just keep your shoulders down. Keep your shoulders down. And then what we do is we transfer the weight, turn, and just do that with the arm. And then we come back, transfer the weight, turn. And then with momentum, that's what gets the punch a bit more. So now make it more like a punch. One, two, three. But keep control. You want to keep it in a controlled punch. You just go into there. And you want to sink. You want to sink. 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 And you got the other hand is the guard. I'll show you that from the side. There's one. Two, three, four, five, that's it, sit. Bring it back to the head each time, so it's like this. So if I do it in slow motion, I go one, tock, tick, tock, tick, tock, tick, tock. So you're moving your hands, you want your hand to be moved by your body. Just leave your hand where it is and allow the body to do the moving for you, and you want to punch with a straight wrist. Punch with a straight wrist. Straight wrist. Punch with a straight wrist. So this bit should be a straight line. I mean, because of how it's shaped, there'll be a bit of a curve there, but it wants to be a straight line. So when you hit something, your wrist doesn't get buffed. Not too much, but get your body mechanics, you're just doing this, body mechanics, six, that's better, seven, eight, and then if you have one foot forward, so if you're right-handed, have your left foot forward, if you're left-handed, have your right foot forward, and then we have front hook, rear hook, so when you've got your front hook, you go into the back leg. And when you do the rear arm, you go into the front leg. Okay, let's try that. So it goes front, rear. Front, rear, just to there. Front, and look. You need to move your feet. One, two. So you're doing this. If you do that with the arm, look. Look what I'm doing with my feet. I lift the toe, I lift the heel, 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 seven, and eight. And then you just do it as like a little, like a loosening exercise, but with a, that's it. Stay down. Boom. Boom. That's better. We'll just keep working on that. And then what we can do is we can go one, two, three, four, kick, kick. So kick, you come like that, flip kick, kick. So it comes around. Boom. Boom. Like a tick. Top. Tick. Arms down, guard down, kick your guard down. That's it. Tip, top, that's it. So we go one, two, three, four, five, six. Right. How fun is that? Okay, let's do, oh my goodness. We better close. So I didn't get any chance. The only bit of the form we did was this. I'm really sorry. I wanted to do the first third of the form. We'll have to do that next week. Never mind. But that was, it's all very useful. Yeah. The thing is, if you can move your body, then when you do the form, it all works better. Yeah. Great. Okay. make it all really noisy, because that will really mess with your hearing aid. We're screaming. And I'd better give them the key. Otherwise I won't know where it is. I won't tell them, no I will. And then, okay, let's do one more. And then, rub the hands together. Oh, there's an induction loop in this building, that's why you can hear well. Not the music. Okay, then we'll just have a musical very quiet. We'll take them off. So, rub the hands together again. And give the flow back a rub. Let's do a few more. Let's do three more and then we'll better. Sorry about not doing the form apart from one bit, that was rubbish, but I'll try and be a bit more organised. Never mind. Okay, nice and relaxed, make a fist with the right hand, left hand over the top, feet together.